Good morning to one and all. In today's lecture, we'll discuss about the DM, that is delta modulation. In previously, we discussed about the PCM, that is your pulse code modulation system. It have many expectations are involved, that is your encoding, decoding and quantizing. So practically, in practical implementation of PCM is very costly. So for that, another digital pulse code modulation technique is used, that is your delta modulation. So in delta modulation, here we have an incoming signal that is oversampled at a Nyquist criteria, that is fs is greater than equals to twice of fm, then there is increase in the correlation between the adjacent samples of a signal. So we can consult it with the help of an example. We can see we have a discrete signals represented by m del t. With respect to t, it has various instant samples. So these samples have correlation between them, which permits the use of simple quantization technique. So for the generation of encoded signal, in delta modulation, we use oversampled version of mt is used. And after then, it is converted to an approximation, that is your staircase approximation denoted by MQT. After that, it get quantized into two levels, that is for positive and negative. So if here we note a point that if your MQT is less than MT, then there will be increment by the delta. And when MQT is greater than MT, then there will be decrease by delta. So we can understand with the help of an example. Here we can see at the DM output, as the sample, this is MT is the modulating signal represented by the line, and these are your levels that are quantized MQT, denoted by MQT. So here this is the staircase approximation. So we can see where the sample, where your modulating signal MT is greater than the level, then you have output at zero. And where you have your staircase approximation greater than your MT, then you will be having the output as 1. Clear? Now, coming on to the basic principle of delta modulation, it is described by the following three discrete time relations. So here we will be discussing three discrete time relations. The first one is your error signal. Here the error signal ENTS is equals to difference between the present sample value of the modulating signal and the latest approximation sample version of modulating signal MNTS. So ENTS is equals to MNTS minus MQNTS minus TS. So now the second relation is your quantized error signal, that is represented by EQNTS, that is equals to delta signum function of ENTS. Here the signum function basically assigns the plus minus 1 value. And the third one is your quantized modulating signal, that is represented by MQNTS. This is equals to MQNTS minus TS plus E suffix Q NTS. Here we note a point that the rate of information transmission is equals to the sampling rate, that is equals to 1 upon TS. Now coming on to the delta modulation transmitter. Here we can see we have input, that is the sampled version of modulating signal MNTS is transmitted by an adder, we have used a comparator over here, and the output of the comparator is denoted by ENTS, that is your error signal. Now this is followed by a quantizer. Here the quantizer is used to scale the version of signum function, that is known as your hard limiter. So it produces the output E suffix Q NTS. Here after then it is followed by an encoder. Here we can see we have a accumulator, that is denoted by MQNTS, is followed by a delayed version, and we get MQNTS minus TS. So here in accumulator, we used an adder and a delayed version. So basically the operation of accumulator is operates on EQ and TS and produce MQ and TS minus TS. That is the latest approximation sample version of your modulating signal M and TS. Now here we assume that the accumulation process starts at T is equals to 0. When it starts at T equals to 0, then MQ and TS is equals to MQ and TS minus TS plus E suffix Q and TS. Now E suffix Q and TS is your delta signal function of E and TS. So in place of E and TS, we can put M and TS minus MQ and TS minus TS from the error signal. So we can put your MQ and TS is equals to MQ and TS minus TS plus delta signal function of M and TS minus MQ and TS minus TS. Now we see over here that if your E and TS, if your error signal is positive, then the modulating sampled version of MT, that is MQ and TS minus TS, should be less than M and TS, then there will be increase in delta function in positive direction. We can see it with the help of an example that there is increment, while when your E and TS, that is your error signal, is negative, then MQ and TS minus TS is greater than your M and TS, then there will be increment of delta function in the negative direction. So here we can see there is increment in the negative delta function in negative direction. So from here we can say here the accumulation is perfect and the track and it tracks the input signal at positive delta function or negative delta function, that is one step at a time. So this was all about the DM transmitter. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the DM receiver. Thank you.